Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
We thank the Lord for this new day. Thank you for giving us this grace together as one family in this Eucharistic celebration. We will be celebration before God and for one another. We acknowledge that we are sinners, that we are in need of God's forgiveness and mercy. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault.
God of might, giver of every good gift, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see. In our hearts we pray with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. For Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Over them harshly and brutally. So they were slaughtered for the lack of a shepherd, and became food for all the wild beasts. My sheep were scattered and wandered over all the mountains and high hills. My sheep were scattered over the whole earth, with no one to look after them or to search for them. Therefore, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, says the Lord God, because my sheep have been given over to my age, and because my sheep have become food for every wild beast, for lack of a shepherd, because my shepherds did not look after my sheep, but pasture themselves and did not pasture my sheep. Because of these shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God, I swear I am coming against these shepherds. I will claim my sheep after them and put a stop to their shepherding my sheep, so that they no longer pasture themselves. I will save my sheep, that they may no longer be food for their mouths. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after a dead my sheep. The word of the
Lord. This is a song that we are singing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pasture, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me and refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread table before me, and the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall
found others standing around and said to them, Why do you stand here idle all day? He answered, because no one has hired us. He said to them, you too, go into my vineyard. When he was eating, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, some of the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first. Then those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received their usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, these last ones work only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat. He said to one of them in reply, my friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to leave this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Everything that we do is God's generosity.
but also what the theme of the extraordinary Jubilee of Mercy reminds us. Be merciful, just as the Father is merciful. Our first reading warns us that we should be like the Good Shepherd, and like the shepherds of old, who patted themselves instead of taking care of the sheep entrusted to them. I quote, "You have fed off the milk, worn the wool, and slaughtered the fatlings, but the sheep you have not mastered. You did not strengthen the weak, nor heal the sick, nor bind them to injury. You did not bring back the stray, not seek the lost, but you lorded it over them harshly and brutally. My sheep you scattered over the whole earth." In the end, the Lord tells them that he will take the sheep from them, and that he himself will look after and tend his sheep. We shall come to the meeting during my second Mass with the clergy and the religious of the Papa. They reminded me, or so they reminded me that my goal is to reveal the face of God who feeds his people, just as Jesus sacramentally reveals himself to us in the Eucharistic celebration. The God who feeds is the God of Christians, as opposed to the pagan gods who are being fed and are angry when they are hungry. This face of God we have to reveal to our words, actions, life, and mission. The Gospel also reminds us that the work of the vineyard of the Lord is a gift. It is His love that calls us to be and to work with Him. We should always be grateful in front of such a privilege. Our experience tells us that we can easily forget this. Sino po ba yung 5 years na as catechist sa atin? Pwede bang itask niyo yung mga yun? According to this ministry, already for 5 years. Pwede itask niyo yung mga yun. Yung mga 10 taon na po. 10 taon, kaya po 10 taon na yun. is this strong sense of entitlement starting to creep in our hearts? Is the joy of the gospel welling up in our heart always for having been given such a privilege to take part in the mission of the Lord? I'd like to conclude with a message I received very early this morning. It says, may God reward us as He wishes, whether we have served Him all our life. His generous reward of sharing life with Him in heaven, His freely is to give, when to give, and to whom to give. No one is really entitled to heaven and God's reward. God bless us all. Amen. God's ways are not our ways, because His justice and generosity exceeds our standards. We come to Him in prayer, knowing that He listens and that He will not fail us. Let our prayer be, Lord, hear our prayer. chalice and once more giving thanks, giving to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May the partakers of Christ and the sacraments we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conform to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
With peace and love of the servant Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.